Hey there, YouTube. Dr. Dualsport. Day after Thanksgiving, November 28th, 3:53. Decided to try to get in a little short ride today. We've got some very unusual weather. The winter's just around the corner, and it's turned off. It's been pretty cool. We've had quite a few 35 degree days. Today, I think it's going to hit like 65. So this is pretty nice. Today I'm riding up what they call the Indian Trail. I guess this was an old trail that when the settlers first came here, they were showed this by the Indians, and that's how they would travel from the valley up to a higher elevation here, where they probably did some hunting for deer and whatever. There's a small little valley above here called Little Valley, and at one time it was actually farmed. Someone told me they used to raise barley up there. We've got some wet snow and ice on the trail today to go along with the rocks and mud, so I don't know how well we're gonna do. We'll see. But one thing about it, you never know if you don't try. I'm not gonna be going too wild, because I don't want to come around a corner and cross it up in some ice or mud. You know, no matter what, this time of year, we always seem to get the change of seasons, and I don't know how it affects you, but I know that it does affect me. As the days get shorter, you know, they tell us that we get less vitamin D from the sun. And that vitamin D kind of helps us in the way that our synaptic nodes, our pleasure centers, the way they react. You know, when the days are longer and there's more sun, I love it. I'm ready to work long hours and get a lot accomplished, feel good about it, whatever. When the days get shorter and less sunlight, I kind of really have to work at it, because I kind of have a tendency to not be as optimistic, kind of almost get a little bit bummed out, you know. So I'm really thankful for this day that, take a little advantage of it, and I'm hoping I can soon get up to where this trail is in the sun, where I can get a little bit better traction. I'm thinking more than likely this will be the last time this year that we'll be able to get up this way, because I'm sure if we, whatever storm comes from now on, will lay here and never melt, because the ground is already cold, and the sun will never touch it. This is a whole different type of riding than there is down in southern Utah, in the St. George area, out in that desert Warner Valley in the Arizona Strip. They have more of a sandy and rocky soils there that it's they very seldom get storm, and when they do, it runs off immediately and dries out rapidly, and so you can get around there pretty well all year long. Here we have more of a clay soil, and it can get pretty gooey. Well, we'll see how we make it. A bit gooey there. Looks like the road's gonna be okay here. It's had the sun on it a little bit. We'll be able to get over through here. A little mud in the eye, better put that down. This is kind of unusual to be able to ride up here end of November. It's almost, we only have a couple of more days in November, we'll be into December. Usually, most years, this would be covered by snow. I'm hoping that I can kind of get myself organized this winter so that I can be able to complete all the work that I need to do as far as on the farm, you know, the farm and ranch, or taking care of the livestock and everything. And then also, I hope I can get a regimen going for proper exercise and diet. I'll just give you a little update on my back. A lot of you, or some of you may know, you've seen my previous videos where after I went to the San Rafael Desert and rode all those trails a couple of months ago, about a week later my back went out on me. And come to find out, all of the vertebrae in my upper back are locked up. They're what they do. They actually, if you just leave it that way, they will, you'll continue to get more arthritis, and they will just calcify and seize up to where you lose all that motion, then you'll also have the continue to get more of the arthritis pain. So far, see, I've been through like a month of treatments three times a week. What they do, they take me in and they apply like electrical stimulus on the muscles along with the damp heat for like 10 minutes. And then the chiropractor would manipulate the your spine or whatever back into alignment where it should be. And each day, my left leg would be like almost close to 3/4 or an inch shorter than the right. Anyway, it's gradually each day, it, it'd go in easier, and then the vertebrae's farther up on the back will continue to start to move. And so when I was in there the last time Wednesday, they did not apply the stimulus or the heat. So from now on, they will just adjust it without. And man, soon in the future, then I'll start into a series of exercises to help to keep that the vertebrae broke loose to where they can move. And I think one thing that's actually healthy for that exercise is riding motorcycles. I think we'll ride up here a little ways. I don't know that we can go that far, but when I stand up on the pegs, and then I flex my legs and my feet and my back, it's a really good exercise, especially for my feet. I have had that plantar tendonitis or plantar fasciitis, especially in my left heel, and it always makes it feel better after I ride the dirt bike for a while. So we'll ride up a little bit farther east here towards these, what they call red cliffs. And I don't know how far we'd be able to go. If as soon as we get off the gravel road, it's going to be probably greasy. And a lot of times the higher the elevation, the more storm you got in your, the wetter it'll be. So I don't know if we can make it up there much farther, but we'll find out. I think by next week we're supposed to drop down 10 degrees again, so it'll be cold again. So it gets harder and harder to find a time and place to ride. And then see, like here, we're hitting the slush, and then we're going to hit the ice. So skate time. Yeah, we'll be turning around here shortly. When it gets icy, we can ride the, when it gets so we can't, like if the valley's covered with snow, we can't find a place to ride the dirt bikes, but we can still ride the bikes on the road, providing the roads are dry. If you have the proper gear, most of my bikes have the heated grips, which are a total lifesaver. And then I also have heated jacket liners, and they'll work on most of the bikes, providing they have, providing they produce enough watts to run the jacket. Because I think the jacket probably takes maybe 100 watts peak. They have a little rheostat, so they'll kind of kick on and off. But if you don't have enough, if your bike doesn't produce enough watts and you're hooked into your battery, you'll eventually get a dead battery. And some bikes will not run with a dead battery. So well, I know from experience that if we try to go up that road, we're not going to be able to make it. Anyway, there's your view. I guess I'll Let's get the old phone here. 4:13. Well, it didn't take us too long to get up here. Let's see. Camera. Well, this is what it's going to be like from now on. As they say, there's days like this, and then they get worse. So one thing I'm going to have to do to avoid the winter blues is that I'm going to have to be proactive. I'm going to have to get up early every day, or I'm going to have to... do proper diet. I'm gonna have to exercise. I'm gonna have to keep myself occupied, and I'm also going to have to count on my friend Tyler, Mr. Eberride down in St. George. He's going to have to let me come down and go for a little ride with him about every 2 or 3 weeks or so. So I'll be able to make it through the winter. And then my ace in the hole is that I have YouTube. I can sit in my soft chair and I can watch YouTube videos, and I can enjoy riding with you folks. And it's almost as good as riding myself. I want to thank all the people that have subscribed to my little channel this year. It's been a fun little hobby. I plan to continue to do it. I plan to continue to ride and enjoy meeting new people. And I hope more of you motor vloggers, if you get a chance to come out to Utah, we would love to ride with you. We can help you out in whatever your needs are, bikes or whatever. Let us know. We want to ride with you. Well, YouTubers, this is Dr. Dualsport. I'm gonna head for the stable and put her away before she gets dark. I hope I can get out and a ride again soon. Until then, this is Dr. Dualsport out.